SistaKeeper was founded to inspire, empower, and develop the mind, body, and spirit of young women into women with a purpose. Established in 2004 by licensed therapist Tracy Barry McGee, this movement has grown to inspire and empower women and young girls all over the world. Here to tell us more about this organization and the program's birth from the movement are founder Tracy Barry McGee and project manager Yolanda Langford. Welcome to the show, ladies.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
And let us know about your mission, how this all started.
Well, it started in 2004, and it's all about girls defining their voices. It started in my basement in our Ferguson, Florissant community. And I think the biggest purpose was how hard it is for girls to struggle through defining themselves in middle school and high school, as well as when they're dealing with bullying and social media issues. And so we thought, why don't we have a program that focuses on culturally relevant material, poetry, journaling, and girls really realizing that when we come together with our mentoring wellness circles, that we are better and we can grow and define our voices.
And you said you started in your basement.
Yes.
With how many young ladies?
We started with 7 girls.
Okay.
And then we end up having a community-based program. We started writing curricula that was introduced to different schools. And then we start traveling the world doing speaking engagements. And now we have chapters in New Mexico, Thailand, Jamaica, Germany, and Ghana. And it just continues to grow. And that's what the mission is all about.
And the one thing I really love about the program is we have grown to a national tour. So we are starting our national tour. It is going to go throughout the United States, and we're going to bring that I Define Me movement to over 2,020 girls. In 2020, that's our goal.
Wow.
That's our goal.
You look back, because it's almost been 20 years. I mean, you're 16 years in.
Yes, it's actually, we started in 2002, and we became a nonprofit in 2004.
Okay. So, well, you should count those 2 years,
because
it takes time.
It is a journey. It is.
And when you started with those, what did you say, 7?
Yes, 7.
What do you feel were the issues back then in 2004, and how you've overcome some of those issues, and how new issues have arrived for young ladies?
Well, the thing that I feel is most important is that we see that our girls have always tried to define themselves. Bullying was really prevalent, but now it's more relational aggression, where someone is left out, and our girls are not defining themselves enough to understand the value of what social emotional learning looks like. So we are increasing that emotional intelligence. When I was growing up, probably when you were growing up, we had that journal and that diary where we were writing out our feelings. Now it's down to like chats and
snaps. It's not even this many fingers, it's this.
Right. And so it's quick and it hurts and it's harmful and it's causing a lot of depression and anxiety, and our girls are shutting down. So some of those things were happening then, as well as some of the culturally relevant issues that we had inside ourselves, that we need to be able to see more, of course, positive social media, positive television, positive radio, and positive interaction as a whole when it comes to what sisterhood looks like.
And more women picking one another up.
Yes, and we always say we're more alike than we are different.
Yes.
If when we get the girls together, our last summit was 250 young ladies.
Yes.
And they were from different schools. However, by the end of the day, they were saying the same pledge. They were asking about different activities they were in. They found out they were more alike than they are different.
And you all brought a few photos too, which we can show that togetherness.
Yes, actually. And the thing about it is they weren't just taking selfies, they were taking usies. Like everybody was coming together.
Yes.
And we provide swag, so we call it a keeper kit, because it's important to develop self-esteem. So we offer a t-shirt when they get that keeper kit. They get the journal, they get bands, and they get all kind of body butters and lip balms. And just different things to say, hey, I define me, not society, not the bully, but me. I define me.
And we always say a sister keeper is you, a sister keeper is me,
a sister keeper is we.
I love it, I love it. Well, stay with us at STL Live. We'll have more with Sister Keeper after this break.